Morning, dear students. Today we are going to draft invitations. This is our writing section topic and it is of 3 marks. 1 mark for format, 1 mark for content, and 1 mark for expression. And we are going to learn how to draft simple invitations. And let me tell you, invitations are of 2 types, formal invitation and informal invitation. We'll talk of formal invitation. Informal is a bit easy and in a letter form or a simple way we can write. But formal invitations, we need to take care of formal language, name of the dignitaries, their designations, proper formal language. Now, let us move to this part now. For drafting invitations, you need to remember very importantly the following points. Start with the organizer. When we start with the organizer means the person who is the host. So followed by the name and address of the host. You might have seen the invitation cards for weddings and birthday parties. The cards, the school annual day cards, they are designed with the beginning of, you know, like host, so and so host, Mr. and Mrs. and Mr. Sharma, feel the honor to invite. So the host details are there. Then if the school is sending an invitation card, we see the management, the staff and the students of so and so school. Like that. So followed by the name and address of the host. We'll share the examples also. Then details of the event, the program, date, time, right? Venue. All these things are very, very importantly taken care. Then the name of the person who has issued, who has sent the invitation. So simple but clear language, value points. Then formal invitations are generally in third person reference, right? Then less use of abbreviations. Then very importantly, the details are to be covered. Let's take an example of, let me share the screen and share some important points. Yes. So, invitations are of 2 types as we discussed, formal and informal, right? So, this way we move on. The informal invitations, relatives, friends, acquaintances, number of social occasions like marriages, births, engagements, and formal invitations are sent to, the chief guest, the principal, or official, you send as having some capacity as an official for any occasion which is official and even outside that also, right? So suppose you are sending the marriage card, wedding card, anniversary, but in a formal way to some authority. So a card is designed in a very wonderful way. So let us share the example. First of all, the format part or important points. As I discussed, I'm again repeating, you can say it as the format also, the name of the host issuing the invitation. The standard expression, because it is a formal. The standard expression here means, like we write, Mrs. and Mr. So and So request the pleasure of company on the occasion of the reason now, occasion of their 25th wedding anniversary or whatever the event or occasion is, right? So time and date of the event, then the venue after the reason, right? So now, if you are inviting some very, very important person, VIP, then his or her name must be there. Printed cards, the name of the invitee may not figure out in the invitation. The date of issuing the invitation is not taken care of. Only when the program is there. No punctuation is required at the end of a line. The simple present tense is used. Now, format of formal invitation. Set host line, invite line, event, date, time, venue. Name of the guest with designation who has given the consent. Say for the chief guest of the annual day is Mr. So-and-so, who is the district magistrate, who is the principal of so-and-so college, or who is the vice chancellor of so-and-so university, like University of Rajasthan, University of Udaipur, whatever. So now this way, and then RSVP, like please respond. Okay, so chief guest with designation and his consent, that he has consented. Honorable sir has consented. Whosoever you have mentioned as the guest has consented as the chief guest to the occasion. So this way, example now. Let's go through the example. It's a beautiful, wonderful example. Your school is organizing the annual day next month in one of the prestigious auditoriums of your city. Maybe your school auditorium. Draft an invitation in not more than 50 words, giving all the essential details. Do not forget to include necessary instructions against mobile phones and cameras or any other instruction that the card is meant for two persons, right? The management, staff and students of Government Model Senior Secondary School, Chandigarh, cordially invite you to their annual function. This is a formal invitation, a designed card, right? The management, staff and students of Government Model Senior Secondary School, Chandigarh, cordially invite you to their annual function, Tara, at 6 p.m., so time, on 4th December 2016, in National Auditorium. Now, Shri Pramod Kumar, Secretary, Higher Education, Ministry of HRD, Human Resource Development, Government of India, so Minister from MHRD, Ministry of Human Resource Development, has consented, Government of India has kindly consented. Now, RSVP, the name of the school, or even the card is principal management. So now, instructions, because the question asked that we need to mention few instructions. So card admits two people only. Please be seated by 5:30. The use of mobile phones and cameras is prohibited. We need to line and write in one line only. The use of mobile phones and cameras is prohibited. Now, accepting the invitation, that we'll share. Afterwards, first we'll share one more invitation to invite or the same invitation. This was the form of a card or formal invitation. Sometimes we send you letters. They are covering letters along with the card. The card is there, but still you draft a letter. So that we cannot call informal, but it is also a formal invitation. Now you need to listen carefully. Inviting a dignitary as a chief guest for school annual day function. Now, the question may arise that how shall we design? This way or the way in the letter form? You can do both ways. It is in the question clearly given. Right? Okay. Now, the name of the school who is inviting. So this is a bit informal, small formal letter form invitation. We also call them covering letters also, children. When we send some invitation card, we send a covering letter, right? But for us, we are attempting an exam. We need to draft an invitation. If it is not written in a letter format, you can draft this way, which is displayed on the screen. If it is particularly asked, that draft the invitation in the form of a small letter form or format, then you will cover up the letter format which we are discussing. So the name of the school who has issued, then date, so then you can say, right? So name of the school, then date, then Shri S. P. Mishra, the district magistrate, civil lines, New Delhi, Chandigarh, whatever the place in the question is. This is bit that letter part, that name of the school is. Now, let's take the topic, drafting petition, drafting an invitation in the letter form, right? A dignitary to be the chief guest of the occasion. Okay, so dignitary to be the chief guest for the occasion. As we discussed that when we are drafting a letter format, so being of the school or the issuing authority or the person who is sending the invitation. So issuing authority address. Right. Then date. Okay. Now it may be issuing authority, maybe school. Right? Saint Joseph School. Right? King Public School. Right? Then the date. Because it is a bit, let us remind ourselves later. Then the person, say for Shri S. M. Mishra, we discussed. Right? The district magistrate. Now we are, and this is New Delhi or whatever the place in the question is. This subject, after that, subject, that is invitation for annual day. It is with immense pride that we wish to celebrate 25th or 26th annual day in the school, right? We cordially invite you to be the chief guest to the occasion, right? And you can even draft this way that it is with immense pride and honor we wish to celebrate our 25th annual day celebration or annual celebrate 25th annual day, right? On so and so date at or in our school auditorium or any famous auditorium of the city, as we discussed, we shall consider it as a great honor to invite you, or we shall consider it as an honor if you could give your consent to be the chief guest, right? We look forward for your presence, right? For the celebration. Kindly confirm through mail. Kindly grace us with your presence on the occasion. We request you, we humbly request you to confirm this through a mail at so and so. Put the email ID, then you can write truly yours, and this way you are yours faithfully, soliciting a line of confirmation for your gracious presence. Regarding your gracious presence, will make us feel honored, right? This way we can write the formal invitation. Now we shared the two different ways of drafting formal of annual day. Now it can be a program related to judging some contest, declination, debate. You're inviting someone to be the judge. It's not only annual day, right? You're sending an invitation to an official, to a card, right? So that card is also the invitation, right? Important points are to write the names properly, the person who is issuing, the organization, the school, university, college that is issuing the invitation, then their designations, whom we are inviting, very important. So, and the words and expressions like it is with great honor, it is with immense pride, that we wish to celebrate so and so. We cordially invite you. We shall consider it as a great honor if you could grace this auspicious occasion with your beautiful presence. Right? So this way we use the formal words. And now let us take one more example. As I discussed, invitation to judge inter-school debate competition. This is example number 2. You are inviting some person for some authority, some popular person for judging the debate competition. So again, the name of the school where the competition is organizing that competition, right? So moving on to the further formal part, after formatting, issuing authority, date, so-and-so, name, Mr. Rahul Sharma, principal, Stephen School, Mumbai. Invitation to judge inter-school debate competition, right? Now it is an inter-school debate competition and we are requesting a judge to accept that. St. Martin has been given the privilege to host this year's inter-school debate competition, English debate competition, right? We would be greatly obliged if you could spare some time from your busy schedule and be the chief guest, right? Chief guest or the judge, chief judge for the event. We are inviting for judging, not the chief guest. So we can make the program is on, the competition is on 25th of December or November between 9:30 or at 9:30, from 9:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. in the school auditorium. Kindly confirm your availability at the earliest and oblige us. You need to ask this line, kindly confirm your availability. Otherwise, we will request some other judge. We can't leave the program, right, without the judge. We can't wait that the judge will come. Guests may be left that they may come and they may. Please send an email. We request you kindly, we kindly request you, we humbly request you to send an email to this. Then you can mention that email. Yours truly, Mr. So-and-so, or your name, whatever department you belong to. If as the capacity of a, in the capacity of a principal you are sending, sending as the head of the department, right? Captain of the school, school captain, student is sending. So that is, these details are in question. I hope your students, you have understood little drafting invitations. We'll continue this drafting invitation tomorrow also, right? So this way we draft, right? Two ways I have taught. One is the card drafting of invitation, inviting, and one formal invitation through a letter. This is hardly of 50 words, 45 to 50 words, not more than that. A short composition. Then we have in our syllabus replies also. We'll be covering in the next class. Right? Thank you. Stay happy and blessed and safe. God bless you all.